Hi, welcome to my review of, let me just turn that camera around. There we go, and that should be, there we go. All right, that'll do fine. Welcome to my review of A Walk in the Woods. A Walk in the Woods starring Robert Redford and Nick Nolte, who is just superb. I love Nick Nolte. Now, this movie, A Walk in the Woods, the title of the movie actually reminds me of a tweet I seen earlier on today. Let me show you this tweet before I get on with the review. It was this tweet here from the World Economic Forum. This black British hiker is tackling exclusion from the outdoors. Mean, have you ever seen Bill Burr talking about Pride, the movie of the first all-black swim team, you know? And he says it's a recreational activity. I mean, nobody's stopping you. There's nobody in the pool stopping black people from swimming, you know? Just like there's nobody stopping black people going for a hike, you know, or a walk in the woods, or excuse me, or a hill climbing, or anything like that, you know? It's the most mundane thing ever, and yet, and they have to make that about, you know, as Malamo Diamanto there says, who I should thank for the very kind donation he gave me a few weeks ago. No one is excluded from the outdoors. She just has to stop hating white people and stop hating herself. But this is the thing, like, nobody's stopping her from going outside and doing that, you know, and so there's not a problem, so they have to create a problem, you know, which just eventually, when they keep doing this, and they do keep doing this, it just causes resentment. I mean, is there going to be, in the next few years, is there going to be like a movie about her life, you know? Let's see, let's go to the article and see what she's saying, right? This black British hiker is tackling exclusion from the outdoors, a diversity gap in outdoor activities means a disproportionate share of visitors to public parks are white and therefore evil, because white people are bad and wrong and evil. I mean, so what? If most people who went hiking were black, I'd say the same thing. So what? Seen a few tweets the other day, somebody pointed them out. It was quite interesting. It was black people on Twitter. And they were saying, why do white people climb mountains? Right? Because you don't really get a lot of black people climbing mountains. Okay. And it's just like, they don't get it. They don't understand why white people do that. There's lots of reasons. One, because they can. It's the feeling of conquering something. It's the challenge, you know? It's to get away from you lot, because we know you're not going to fucking be there calling us racist. It's, you know, the view, you know, the peace and quiet, you know, the difference. They don't get it. They don't. It doesn't make sense to them. Why would you go up there? There's nothing up there. There's actually a lot up there. You just don't get it. So fine, it's not for you. That's totally fine. In the US, around 90% of visitors to public parks are white and therefore evil, despite making up about 60% of the population. Right? And I would be willing to bet that the majority of people in the world who play snooker and darts are white as well. So what? There's nobody stopping black people from playing darts. It's just the way it is, right? They just make an issue out of nothing so that it can be all about them. As I've said before, black people don't care about racism. The thing that upsets them the most is indifference from white people. So when she goes hiking, right? White people go, whatever, right? We don't go, hoopla, hey, let's have a fucking celebration. Look at that person going hiking. We don't care. We don't care. And it bugs her that we don't care. It bugs her that it doesn't interfere with our lives in any way. It really bothers her that we're indifferent. One UK hiker has created a community for women of colour to help make outdoor activities more inclusive. But that's the complete opposite of inclusive. She's trying to change the hiking community, if there is such a thing. She's trying to change it into little special groups. Why can't you just go hiking and enjoy it with other people who go hiking, no matter what they look like? No, we've got to have a little separate group so that you feel special as a woman and as, oh no, it's women of colour, so I don't even think it's women and people of colour. I think it's specifically women of colour, which means not white women. That's what it means. That's what it means, because believe me, a Chinese woman could get into this group, you know, because she's not white and therefore evil. You know, that's how this is, that's how the whole thing works. She wants to separate herself and all the other hikers, women of colour, for what reason? Oh, to be more inclusive. In other words, to get rid of those white people who are more likely to do it. Why don't you go with the white people? They do it more often, right? So maybe they'd have some tips for you. Maybe you're using the wrong footwear, you know? You know, the funny thing is as well, there's actually a shop here in Britain, right? And it specifically caters to hikers. It sells like the boots, the tents and all that. Do you know what the shop is called? Can you guess what the shop is called? It's called Blacks. I mean, for fuck's sake, it's actually called Blacks. As corporations, governments, organisations and educational institutions confront what diversity and inclusion looks like from the inside, one UK hiker has created a community for people of colour outdoors. Oh, it's people now, not just women. And here's the thing as well, right? This is really bugs me about these arseholes, is they don't know what diversity means, right? 90% of, let's take all white people who go hiking, right? They're all diverse. Do you think they all have the same opinions and like the same music and go to the same holiday destinations and eat the same food and have the same sexual preferences and watch the same movies and watch the same TV shows? And is that what you think? They all have the same hobbies outside hiking? Is that what you think? The only thing they have in common is the fact that they hike. That's it. They might all be different. They might all have different political beliefs and all that kind of stuff. No two of them might be the same. You know, you might get two people who are right-leaning politically, but one of them might be gay and, you know, another one's straight and one of them's black. Oh no, they're all white, sorry. One of them prefers Asians as sexual partners, the other one prefers dwarfs. I don't fucking know. The point is, they're already diverse, but you're so fucking stupid and ignorant, or as black Americans like to say, ignorant. How ironic. You're so stupid and ignorant that you think that diversity only comes from appearance, how you see it. So if you see five people who are white, you think, well, they must all be exactly the same. Why do you think that? Because you're a fucking racist. That's why you think that. Whereas when you see a white person, a Chinese person, a fucking black person, fucking whatever else, a Hispanic person, when you're not counting them as white to boost up the crime statistics, when you see all them, you think, oh, they're diverse, but they might all be the same. They might all have the same tastes and opinions. You're fucking stupid and annoying as fuck. Totally obnoxious. They're all, as Bill Burr says when he says, they're all the way down to swimming. They're all the way down to hiking. They've managed to go lower. They're all the way down to hiking. And I gotta be honest, I don't think I give a fuck. Ryan, Rianne, Fatin, or whatever, huh? Founded Black Girls Hike. Oh, for fuck's sake, should I click on this? I'm clicking on it. What are you giving me here? Black Girls Hike. It's a, oh, Jesus Christ. This is, right, okay. Black Girls Hike, okay then. Like, it's 872, not, following, it's six, just nearly 6,500 followers, or just over 6,500 followers. to this Instagram page. Black Girls Hike, oh, well done. Yeah. I mean, difficulty hard. You know, I mean, what's the difference between you hiking and, say, me hiking? Like, when we get to the destination of the hike, like, say it's at the top of a hill, right? I'll maybe take some photos. What do black girls do? Do they, like, I don't know, do they, like, twerk or something? Or have kids out of wedlock? What do they do when they're hiking that's different from what I would do? It's so fucking stupid, man. It really is so fucking stupid. And as you can see there, black girls hike, so it's not people of colour then, is it? It's not women of colour. It's black people. Black women. That's what it is. How fucking specific is that? They're way out in the wilderness and they've got fucking masks on. Maybe they're dressed as sheep for Halloween. Fuck's sake, man. Oh, look, here's some photos. What's this one? Jesus, man. Yep, I'm racist. Kind of proud of that, actually. So she founded Black Girls Hike in 2019 to encourage black women to explore the UK countryside in the safety of sisterhood. Safety? What? Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Are we to believe that white supremacists, which apparently I'm one, I get called that nearly every day, but are we to believe that white supremacists are out there stopping black women from hiking and that's what makes it unsafe? How is it safety? What the fuck are you talking about? Fatin her came up with the idea when she noticed there were few people who looked like her involved in the hobby. Who gives a shit if they look like you? I mean, this is so fucking ridiculous, man. I mean, it's like me going hiking with a group of hikers, you know, and then complaining that one of them's black. It's, yeah, what are you doing here? You don't fucking look like me, beat it. It's kind of, you know, or they're all white, but hang on. You've all got brown eyes. What the fuck? I've got blue eyes. None of you look like me. God. It's as if that's important. It's as if... I really wanted to enjoy this walk in the wilderness, see nature, get away from the city, get the phone off, get away from the city, get away from everything, peace and quiet, a nice walk, good bit of exercise. But I need people that look like me as well, doing it at the same time as me, otherwise I can't do it safely. These fucking people. Oh. I think if there was a court case, right, and I was in court, and the court case was that, like, I'm racist, or, like, I'm racist, right? And I'm the one making the case, and I'm saying, no, I'm racist, and people are saying, no, he's not racist. I think I could convince a jury that I'm justified in being racist. I think showing them things like this, loads of things like this, I think eventually they would go, you know what, I can kind of see his point. I kind of see where he's coming from here, you know? Because they're fucking obnoxious. Good God, man. Just go for a fucking walk. Hiking is often considered a white-dominated activity. It's not, though, is it? When has it ever been considered that? When you got involved and wanted to make it all about your skin colour. Wanted a big fucking party because you're doing something. Nobody cares. And the Greater Manchester resident wanted to do her part to change that. Why? Can we change the NBA as well? Because it's mostly blacks that play basketball. Can we change that? The lack of representation in hiking is clear for all to see. Not really. I mean, not really. She told Women's Health this year. It's never something... So wait a minute. You got an interview with Women's Health magazine? That's a pretty big magazine. So you're not that oppressed then, right? You're not that invisible. It's never something I associated with black people. Well, that's your fucking problem, isn't it? It's not even marketed at black people. Wait a minute here. Do you notice that black is capitalised and white isn't? Do you notice that? Isn't that like a form of racism? I mean, no doubt they would twist it and say, no, it's racism towards blacks because why is black capitalised for some reason? You know, they'd find a way to make it them the victims in it. I wasn't keen on the prospect of venturing out alone or joining a typical hikers group because you're racist. Where there'd be nobody I could identify with. How can you not identify with other hikers? That's kind of racist, that. Because You've all got the same hobby. There you go, there's a connection right there. How can you not identify with these people? Why don't you try and talk to them? I mean, you'll probably find that they're quite friendly. I mean, they're hikers. We're talking about hikers here. God, man. The idea for Black Girls Hike was born. She launched an Instagram profile for the group and planned their first meetup last year. Since it began, 150 women have joined on 19 different hikes. Together they have scaled Snowdon, the highest peak in Wales. Right, why did you climb that? Why did you climb that? What's that about? What's up there? There's nothing up there. Black people told us. Her experiences illustrate the wider issue of a lack of diversity in public parks. This is real as well. This isn't even a joke. This whole thing is real. It's real. We're living in a time, the planet's billions of years old, and we're living in a time when this is real. This is the concern for them, that mostly white people that hike. And it was mostly blacks that went to see Black Panther. Should we change that? Who gives a shit, man? You fucking people. In the US, around 90% of visitors to public parks are white and therefore evil, despite making up 60% of the population. The lack of minority visitors on public lands... Wait a minute. The lack of minority visitors? White people are the world's minority. So, you've got minority visitors. What's your problem here? On public lands could be linked to affordability and access. No. Unless you have to pay to hike on private land, which is not the case. I used to go hiking with my dad when I was younger, and he had the big book, big AA book of hiking places, you know. And it was fucking great. And there was loads of them, fucking thousands of them up and down the country, all over Britain, and they're free. It's like completely free. You know, I think that was one of the reasons that we went hiking, you know. I didn't give a fuck, I liked hiking. But it's free. You don't need to own a mansion to go hiking. And also, black people can own mansions. Some parks have entrance fees. Right, okay, go to another one then. Are unreachable by public transport. That's the... I'm going to cry. That's the point. It's a way out in the wilderness, away from the city. Not, they're unreachable by public transit. Now, you usually get, like, hiking groups, but then they're white, so therefore evil. But you usually get hiking groups with white people, and I'm sure you can put up with their evilness in order to hitch a ride to the hiking place. You know, there's always little buses and minibuses and all that going to these places. So stop talking shit or require expensive equipment. Yes, but this is a one-off thing. You don't need to buy a new pair of boots every time you go hiking. There is also a history of prejudice tied to outdoor activities. Oh, for fuck's sake. I've never heard of this in my life. Until 1964, oh, for fuck's sake, we're back last century, right? Okay, we're back in last century, before the colour TV. Okay, right, okay. Let's hear it. Before widescreen, let's hear it. What's the problem in 1964 before you were born? Let me hear it. Segregation laws were still in place at public recreation sites, including parks. What the fuck has that got to do with you going for a hike today? A 2018 study found 66% of US blacks surveyed associated the outdoors with lynching, slavery and police brutality. Oh, fuck off, man. This is just fuck off. That says something about the education system in America, I'll tell you that much. 66% of blacks associated the outdoors with lynching, slavery and police brutality. Oh, aye. Because remember all those blacks getting killed by police when they were in the woods going for a fucking hike? Do you remember when they were lynched? Going for a fucking hike. Remember that case 2 years ago when that black guy was going for a hike and a bunch of whites fucking trapped him in a big net and turned him into a slave? Oh, I remember that. You fucking lunatics. Good God, man. This is like fucking centuries ago, this shit, and you're still going on about it. And police brutality, don't even get started with that shit. Fucking bollocks, man. Oh, I can't go hiking, why? Because, I don't know, fucking Trayvon Martin or some shit. I don't, fucking idiots, man. Stop watching CNN. Research shows access to green spaces can help with depression, decrease stress, and improve physical health. As society leans into the health benefits of nature, it's important that all cultures and ethnicities feel safe and welcome outdoors. No, no, wait a minute. There are some places, especially in America, where you're never going to feel safe outdoors because there are bears, you know, there are wolves. I mean, you're not guaranteed to feel safe. And it's like, when they talk about this shit, it's important that all cultures and ethnicities feel safe. What they mean is that they feel safe from white people. But the reality is that they're the unsafe ones to white people. Oh, we can't talk about that, though. I'm proud that we're challenging stereotypes. Yeah, actually, you're not. You are a fucking total stereotype. Oh, I'm a victim because I'm black. I need special treatment because I'm black. You're a total stereotype. And showing people that the outdoors is for everyone, representation really does matter. If you're a hiker, you're a hiker. You're represented in the hiking community. It doesn't matter what you look like, you fucking idiot. The group is currently raising money, of course they are, to create nature retreats to help women heal from traumatic events. Oh, now it's all about women now. Why can't you just go for a fucking hike and stop making everything about your own personal grievances? The retreats will include trained counsellors and wellness workshops, along with forest bathing, yoga and meditation. I'm sorry to tell you this, but that's not hiking. This is what women do. They go into something like hiking, which is about hiking, and then they go, you know what, this is a bit boring, you think we should throw some yoga in here? No, you can't throw some yoga in here, because then it's not hiking anymore, is it? Now it's yoga. You want to go to yoga? Go to fucking yoga. Fucking hell, man. These fucking people, I swear to God, it's a constant pat on the head. Oh, well done for you going hiking. Oh, did you see that? What? A black person went hiking. Oh, did the black person go hiking? Oh, how special, how tremendous for you. Let's do a fucking party for you. Let's have a fucking statue just for you for going hiking, you fucking stupid bitch. Fuck's sake. And why are they like this? I'm going to show you another tweet, right? Why are they like this? Because this is how they get treated. I noticed this the other day as well. Look, this is from Twitch. Completely different subject, but look at this. Get ready to jump into the Motherlands. A futuristic RPG adventure. Ooh, sounds good. Series hosted and developed by an all-star team. Ooh, all black and POC talent. Oh, for fuck's sake. Why didn't you just stop? Why didn't you just stop there? Why did you have to tell me that they're black and people of colour? In other words, they're not white. Why did you have to tell me that, Twitch? You see, this is what I'm talking about. Where black people, as my tweet there, I said, I'm so sick of black people being catered to like they're mentally ill children. I will avoid this game, right? And of course, you get blacks coming in and taking offence at what I said, even though I am defending them, right? Because what I should have said is, get ready to jump into the Motherlands, a futuristic RPG adventure series hosted and developed by an all-star team. Done. Full stop. End of story. Shut the fuck up. Don't tell me they're black and people of colour. Why? Because if they were white, you wouldn't have mentioned it, right? And when you say black and people of colour, this is what it sounds like, right? You see a 25-year-old man, right? A grown fucking adult, right? He goes on his knee and he ties his shoelace. And you stop and you go, oh my God, well done. What? Well done, you just tied your shoelace, that's fucking amazing. Well done, have a pat on the head from me. Well done, hey everybody, this guy just tied his shoelace, did you see that? Did you see that? You see how fucking insulting that is? Of course he can tie his fucking shoelace, he's 25. What the fuck is wrong with you? That's what you're doing here. Look everybody, the black people made a game, look. Of course black people can make fucking games, what the fuck is wrong with you? Jesus Christ. Oh, you've got to make a big deal about them being black. Now I don't want the game. Thanks. I would have checked it out because I like RPGs. I'm not even going to check it out now. all because you had to make a big deal about their skin colour, which was not relevant. And this is why they want a big pat on the head when they go hiking, because they keep getting pats on the head for mundane shit like this. Black people made the game. Oh, what they fucking do? So what? God, man. Black people have been making games for fucking years. Now all of a sudden, they should... See this here. This tweet here about that. This is the kind of thing that black people should be offended at. This is the real racism. You are getting a pat on the fucking head and they're making a big noise about it. Twitch is a big account, right? And they're making a big noise about it. Why? Because you're black. Look what those black people did. That black person drew a stick man. Well done, hey! Let's all clap for the black person who did something that anybody from any demographic can do, you know, pretty much. Let's give them a round of applause, everyone, yay! So fucking insulting. It is unfucking believable how insulting that is. But of course they don't see it. They don't see it, you know. None of them say anything except me, you know. It seems kind of exclusive, but okay, there's a black guy saying that, you know. This was the team that put it together, and the players in the friend group who they felt comfortable having be the first to play it. It's going to be a system for all to enjoy. He's claiming exclusivity because they're talking about just black people. Why did they have to mention that? They could simply have stopped right there, an all-star team. But no, they had to tell us, didn't they, that they weren't white and therefore evil. They had to fucking tell us that, didn't they? Because that's the important thing here. God. Anyway, I'm really sorry. I was off topic there. I should really get back to my movie review. A Walk in the Woods. It's okay if you like that kind of thing, I suppose. Anyway, thank you very much for watching my movie review. I hope you liked it. I'll try to get some more out this month. Until next time.